Get ready for the dictation. Dictation will start in 5 seconds. Start. When we understand the factual matrix in the backdrop of the objectives of the above two legislations, the controversy in the instant case assumes immense significance. There is an interest of the bank in recovering the non-performing assets on the one hand and protecting the right of the blameless tenant on the other. The Rent Control Act must be construed as such. A landlord cannot be permitted to do indirectly what he has been barred from doing under the Rent Control Act. More so when the two legislations, that is the Surfacey Act and the Rent Control Act, operate in completely different fields. While Surfacey Act is concerned with non-performing assets of the banks, the Rent Control governs the relationship between a tenant and the landlord, with specifies the rights and liabilities of each as well as the rules of abjectment with respect to such tenants. These provisions of the Surfacey cannot be used to override the provisions of the Rent Control Act. If the contentions of the Learned Counsel for the respondent banks are to be accepted, it would render the entire scheme of all Rent Control Acts operating in the country as useless and nugatory. Tenants would be left wholly to the mercy of their landlords and in the fear that the landlord may use the tenanted premises as a security interest while taking a loan from a bank and subsequently default on it, and the landlord would simply have to give up the tenanted premises as a security interest to the creditor banks while he is still getting rent for the same. In the case of default of the loan, the maximum brunt will be borne by the unsuspecting tenant, who would be evicted from the possession of the tenanted property by the bank under the provisions of the Surfacey Act. Under no circumstances can this be permitted, more so in view of the statutory protections to the tenants under the Rent Control Act and also in respect of contractual tenants along with the possession of their properties which shall be obtained with due possession of law. The issue of determination of tenancy is also one which is well settled while section 106 of the Transfer of Property Act does provide for registration of leases which are created on a year-to-year basis. That needs to be remembered is the effect of non-registration of the creation of tenancy by way of an oral agreement. According to Section 106 of the Transfer of Property Act, a monthly tenancy shall be deemed to be a tenancy from month to month and must be registered if it is reduced into writing. The Transfer of Property Act, however, remains silent on the position of law in cases where the agreement is not reduced into writing. If the two parties are executing their rights and liabilities in the nature of a landlord-tenant relationship, and if regular rent is being paid and accepted, then the mere factum of non-registration of need will not make the lease itself nugatory, full stop.